In today's video, we're going to be having a look at 12 of my favourite features that were added to Home Assistant across the course of 2021. Check it out. What's going on, guys? I hope you're all doing well. 2021 was a great year for Home Assistant. We received a whole bunch of new features, new enhancements, new fixes, and much, much more. And it didn't just end there. Every month we had a new update released from the developers, and with each release, the Home Assistant developers did a live stream where you could tune in for free on YouTube and just watch it with the developers and run through all the new features and enhancements. And it also gave you the chance to talk to the developers and ask any questions that you might have had about the update. And as I mentioned, those streams are all available on YouTube, and you'll find them over at the official Home Assistant YouTube page, and I'll have a link to this in the description below. Moving on then, we're going to rewind this back to the beginning of the year, and we're going to kick this off with update 2021.1. As updates go, 2021.1 was a relatively small update, and that's just due to the fact that the previous update, 2020.12, was a massive update for Home Assistant, and of course, it was the Christmas holidays. My favourite feature of the January update was some of the new changes made to the new Apple TV integration. In a previous update, the Apple TV integration was completely rewritten by Pierre Stahl, and it allowed you to make better use of Apple TVs within Home Assistant. So the update in 2021.1 just gave it a bit more functionality and some extra bits of information. I also only discovered the Apple TV integration at this time, so for me it was a brand new integration and it allowed me to control the various Apple TVs in my home. Stepping forward into February then, we had the release of update 2021.2. Update 2021.2 was a great release. It contained the first release of the Z-Wave or Z-Wave JS integration. It contained some new cloud text-to-speech settings, and also it contained a new Python update, moving to Python 3.9. But my favourite update of this release is DHCP Discovery. DHCP Discovery allows Home Assistant to listen to your network for devices that request an IP address, and based on the intercepted messages, Home Assistant can discover integrations that can be used with the discovered devices. And you will have seen this in action within your own Home Assistant. So in the bottom left of your Home Assistant, you'll see the little notifications tab, and usually you'll see a little pop-up there to tell you that you've got a notification. And when you click that, it will tell you that it's discovered a new integration. And from there, you can just proceed to set up that integration and get those devices and other bits added into your Home Assistant. Moving into March, we had the 2021.3 update. This update released with 13 brand new integrations, as well as a whole host of other fixes and improvements, but my favourite feature of this update was the My Home Assistant feature. The My Home Assistant feature allows Home Assistant documentation, forums, chats, web blogs, and other websites link directly to specific pages in your Home Assistant instance, all without knowing the URL of your instance. And the reason this is so useful is the fact that you can add a link somewhere on a web page or a bit of documentation and have that directly open in someone else's Home Assistant instance. So like in Frank's handy example there, there's a link to the Hue integration. And when you click that in the Home Assistant documentation, it will take you directly to the Hue integration, but within your own Home Assistant. Next up, we've got the April release of 2021.4. Now this one was a great one for advanced users, but also for new users just starting to experiment with Home Assistant automations. The update added a feature that's primary goal is to help you fix and correct automations that you create and write. And that feature is of course automation debugging, and it does exactly that. So you get presented with this visual graph, and on that graph you can see the route that an automation took, and you can click on the various interactive nodes to find out what the automation was doing at a specific point in time. Moving forward another month, we had the May release of 2021.5. 2021.5 added a feature that finally answered the question of why is my Home Assistant taking so long to start up? So startup visibility was added, and what this does is it adds a little notification section to the bottom corner of your Home Assistant, and basically when it's starting up it just tells you what it's doing at a particular point, so you can see what section of Home Assistant is taking the longest to start up. And if you do happen to miss that startup notification, you can head into your information tab and you can view a breakdown for each of the integrations and see the setup time for each one and find out which one is causing Home Assistant to take a long time to start up. We then had the June update of 2021.6. This particular update didn't contain any big new features, but it was jam-packed full of small features and improvements, and also some great new UI changes. My favourite feature of this update was the support for custom dark mode on themes, and this gave front-end developers a new way to create themes, so you could have a single page theme and it could have the ability to have a light mode or a dark mode variant. Then along came July with the 2021.7 update, and this update brought us a similar feature that we had in the April update. So in the July update of 2021.7, we got script debugging, so similar to automation debugging, except you could now debug your scripts. So the same thing here, you could have that visual look at the graph and you could break down all the different nodes to find out what your script was doing at various different points. And then into August with the 2021.8 update, and I think the biggest Home Assistant update of the year. 2021.8 brought us lots of new features and additions, but the main focus of this update was energy management and long-term statistics. The Energy Dashboard allows Home Assistant users to quickly and simply set up a dashboard that provides you with information about your energy distribution. The dashboard allows you to just quickly glance and find out what energy is being produced and what's being consumed, and you can also track individual devices and you can view a timescale of all the energy consumption and usage. So if you wanted to find out what it was over a set number of days, weeks, months, or even years, you can do. You can also create your own energy dashboards. So if you want to visualize something in a specific way, or you want to have some kind of custom card, then you can also do that if that's something that you want to do. Then along came September with the 2021.9 update, and they added a feature that I felt should have always been part of Home Assistant.
USB discovery.
So gone are the times when you plug in a Z-Wave or a Zigbee stick to Home Assistant, then you have to manually configure and set up the path. Now all you do is just simply plug in the USB stick and it will automatically prompt you with an integration to set up and get everything configured for you. I personally love this feature, and it's just one of those steps that Home Assistant have taken to make it easier and more intuitive for other users. So you don't have to be super technically savvy to just plug in a USB stick. You don't have to do that configuration. It's just more friendly and welcoming to new users. We then had the October release of 2021.10, and we got a whole stack of new integrations, including the new two-year integration and even more improvements to the Z-Wave JS integration, which at this point now, it was time to bite the bullet. And if you weren't already on Z-Wave JS, it was time to move over to it. Home Assistant also turned 8 years old, and the guys over at Home Assistant had a huge announcement with the Home Assistant Yellow, which is some dedicated hardware designed and customly made to run Home Assistant. And if you're interested in picking yourselves up a Home Assistant Yellow, you'll find a link to it in the description below. Back over in update 2021.10, my favorite feature of this update was the update to Material Design's icon, bringing it up to Material Design's icon version 6. And this gave Home Assistant over 400 new icons to make use of within your Home Assistant dashboards. I'm a huge fan of Material Design icons, and it was great to see that over 75 of those icons were all specifically made for Home Assistant. And to follow along with my love of the Material Design icons, we of course got the Icon Picker. The Icon Picker is absolutely fantastic, and not only is it super simple to just select an icon or search for an icon, it actually loads crazy fast. And it's so much faster than going to the Material Design's icon page and doing a search for an icon there. It just takes ages to do that. This is super quick, super simple, and it just allows you that bit of freedom to customize and choose icons. We then had the final release of the year, which was the December 2021.12 update, which I unfortunately didn't get to cover in its own individual video. This update was a great update to finish the year on, and it was just jam-packed full of new features. We had the brand new configuration panel, we had the button entity, we got the redesigned area panel with the new Area Lovelace card, we got blueprint scripts, we got a whole host of new integrations, and we got my favorite feature, which was the ability to create a user account that could only log into your Home Assistant if they're connected to your local network. Now, this is personally a feature that I really love, and I've wanted it in Home Assistant for a long time, so I'm glad that it's finally here and glad that it's part of the last update. And there we go, guys. That was a quick look at 12 new features that got added to Home Assistant in 2021 that I personally really liked. If you've enjoyed this video and found it useful, then don't forget to drop me a like. And if you're not already, hit that subscribe button and ding dong the notification bell. You'll then be alerted to any future video that I do. And as always, a massive thank you to these awesome dudes. These awesome dudes are my Patreons. If you're interested in helping support my channel, which in turn allows me to create content like this, then you'll find a link to my Patreon in the description below. And just one last thing before we wrap this up, a massive thank you to the guys over at Home Assistant and Nabucasa for all the work that they've done throughout 2021 to get Home Assistant to where it is. And another massive thank you to all of the community members that also put in work to help enhance and improve Home Assistant. So thank you for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.